Yes, I'm back again. This time around, you can see I'm a little bit fully kitted. Yes, because it's time to fumigate. Well, I'm going to walk you through the aspect of fumigation so that you see how I do it on my own farm. Remember, I know you're not a novice, and even if you're a novice in this, well, you can still learn, because I believe that you've had some form of research, if possible, through questions and answers. Now, in fumigating my brooder section, or my brooding section, my farm, I like to get myself all dressed up for it. Why? Because I'm dealing with chemicals, and it's important that I take precautions. Health as well. Besides, if I'm not healthy enough, will I be able to take care of the birds? No. Now, already, since I'm not fumigating the whole farm, I already have my water not full level, my quarter section. And then I have my fumigants here. The chemicals I use for fumigation. Normally, you can get to a fumigation store around you, or most of the times, the veterinary shops do have these fumigants there. So I sometimes patronize them. I had this and it's almost finished, so I'll still be using it. And then I definitely would not start anything if I haven't covered myself up. So first and foremost, I put my gloves on, because it's very, very important. I wouldn't joke with that. I'm dealing with chemicals, and it's good I get myself protected. You know, even in this era of coronavirus, we as poultry farmers, we have already started putting ourselves towards it, because the life of the birds itself is so important. So I get my gloves on. And I like using the thick ones, the thick cloth ones. Some people like the normal rubber synthetic. I like the thick cloth one, because that would be hard on. And so, while doing that, I add my fumigant. Well, things I'm not doing much, so normally I measure them, but this is just one. I want my bed having a nice time, you know. Most of the times, during the mosquito session, you have everyone coming, so I use my deep heat spray. You may also want to ask, what are my feeders doing here, my small feeders? I always like fumigating them before washing, I like them being fumigated, and then when washing, I'll now disinfect them. So I get everything all buckled up. Why is this aspect so important? It is because, like I said earlier in the first video, this is the most important aspect of the bed life, and we need everywhere to be safe for them, so that they could be healthy and they could have the expected result in which we want it. And once I'm done with this, I like going for the longer ones. You can see I've dragged out my pole. It helps me to be able to reach the rooftops inside, so that I don't have issues when I'm working with them. So I like having them. So this comes from the inside. I lock up and I lock the door inside when I want it to be. It's comfortable like that. Okay. Now, last but not the least, I have to get myself geared. You may laugh, especially how I look. But well, you know, I'm dealing with chemicals, and in form of fumigating, I could have things drop on my head. I wouldn't want them touching my skin, so I have to get myself covered up. I like going for the women own, the female one, because it's quite synthetic in the sense that it's rubber. And then when I use it, whatever drops on it, I can wash it up. Now, I'm ready to fumigate. I pick my knapsack sprayer, wear it,
that takes a while.
Oops. Yeah. Okay. All about that. Well, like I said, you may have different ways of fumigating yours. This works for me, and it's always good. Before I start, I try to test it. I'm good to go. It's ready. And so I can now come in. So come with me.
First,
yeah. And so I have to open all places up. You know, I have cartons. Like I said earlier, you need to start getting your cartons ready. I started getting mine because we'll need them. You notice you have. I have coverings here. So, let's start. I don't necessarily need to climb. That's why you're seeing that I have to use a longer dip knapsack sprayer with a long neck stick itself. I hope I got the name correct. I normally call it the iron stick. So that I don't need to climb. I can still be fumigating.
And so, the fumigation has started. And I take it line by line. I usually enjoy this part. Sorry, I might not be able to face you, but you'll be able to feel. I start with the walls, go up the roofs. You can see I have that corner down there. I'm always so particular about it. Let me pull it out.
Just walk with me. I'll stop there for now. I have to calm down. Well, I might have to kneel a little in order to get the job done. I still start from the walls. Make sure that you get all sides covered. You know that you're dealing with wood, and so I have to ensure that I spray it also on the wood to ensure that I don't have any issues, especially with termites. I have to get that all up. Very important to get the woods. I used wood on mine too. This is where I'll stop. Not as regards the fumigation, but to the next step. Now, because I have a blind, I will loosen it. Because like I said, I'm going to cover it all up so that... Oh, here it goes. This is very, very important. Some of you have a setup like mine. I like putting it down. Like I said, please subscribe so that you have more notifications on the videos that will come. Because after now, much later in the day, I'll be telling you the certain things that you need before you stop. Like I showed you one earlier, the pattern is very, very important. In case you're using, you also need some backpack. I have not covered this, and this will be the last part of it. So I'll have to walk through the process of fumigating again. Well, I hope you're able to see this. I'll just know that I'm fumigating again. And this time around, I'll ensure that it spreads itself on this. And I also spread some on the cardboard itself, the plywood, which is as it is. So ensure that you spray yours like that. Sure you do that to have everywhere so messy, but you want to make them look so uncomfortable inside. Whatever germs that are there, parasites, anything that will make your beds not give you the expected yield, you have to work on it now. That's what I'm doing, I'm ensuring that everywhere is done. I've done this part, close it.
all that is done. I cover it too. You can see that. And I walk down to this other area here. Now this is the base, so it's more of cement. So I have to make sure I spray it also on the floor. I'm spraying the nettings of the door. It's important too. So once I'm done with this, I close this other side too. Okay, it goes down. Now once this is done, I have to also spread it. Sorry. Aspect of talking is better. Also, going to come to the aspect of foundation. So I have to spray here. Sorry, I'm still here. But like I said, foundation doesn't work too well with cameras. So having done this, I'll be coming out, and then we get outside there. Now I make sure I also concentrate on the aspect that has the dip. It's regular, it's going to have what I need. So now I have to get to this and come to my hand area. Now, also, like I said, I have my small feeders here, so I have to get them. By the time I want to wash them off, the big drinkers you want, big feeders you want to ask where I haven't done that. Well, they're still hanging, but so I'll bring them and do that also, and I will do it. Like I said, spread it around. I'm also going to walk you through to where I keep my droppings. When I remove them, you know, when it rains, you have to clear your place, the farm, if the droppings, the foul odor is disturbing. And because it's residential, I also live here. So I have to ensure that everywhere is clean, the odor is not offensive. So let me take you to where I put those droppings when I have removed the sodom. I think from here, it's still part of it. It's important because once I'm done with this, I would have to drop this down. I have this also here, and it helps me for rains, to stop the rains if they are much, or wind if it's too much, and it helps. I also use it around the surrounding. Sawdust when I have removed from the poultry farm. So I have to put this here also very well. I still have some fuel from the last set here. So I regularly fumigate this so that we will not have mosquitoes and the likes about, bacteria, all of them having a field day over here. So I ensure that I fumigate every side. Make it good enough and have it good enough.
cups. I have some little drinkers. Give me a minute while you focus on that side. I'll bring my big drinkers. To bring out. Why my worker is still trying to loosen the other ones. So I fumigate all. So in case I have anything that is in it, you know, all this bacteria can go around. And I want my guests to be feeling happy.
You know, when you get into a new house, you always want everyone to be good. So it's important. You can see the length of this. I don't need to stretch. All I need to do is just move it up. That's almost so good. It makes me feel everything.
Okay. Yeah, I think that is done. Yeah. Woo! Oh, sorry. I'll come back to you later. Well, I know you have some few questions. My nose wasn't covered. Yes, that's true. Well, it will be in the next one. But for now, I had to leave in time. The weather is changing, and I really need to hurry up so that you won't miss that part of fumigating. Now, I've gotten my hand gloves off because I believe I'm done. First, let me remove what made me look feminine and funny. But like I said, everything is covered and it's so good. So, after I've done this, I'll seal everywhere up. It's covered. And that's how it's going to be for today. Tomorrow is Sunday, so I need to go and thank God. My people, I need to go to church. Go praise God. Be grateful. It's not easy, especially during this global pandemic. So, tomorrow, our live will still be sealed like this. And then Monday, we'll be coming to the farm where we'll open and we'll start the process of cleaning up and then disinfecting. That time we'll bring out all the feed trees, bring out all the small feeders, the drinkers, be washing them and airing them and drying them and preparing for our host. No, I'm the host. We're preparing for our guests. Yes, the day old chicks are our guests, and so we need to prepare for them. So, on the long run, I've walked you through how I fumigate my farm. Later on, much later in the day, or maybe tomorrow, after church, in a very restful mood, I'll be telling you on the things we need in order to prepare for our guests, the day old chicks, when they'll be arriving. Well, I'll not tell you the company I'm using, but I think I should be able to let that secret out, but not now. The essence, I'm not trying to pick on the company of birds, or I think we have good companies here. Well, they are all the same. It all boils down to biosecurity, especially in poultry. And I'm going to walk you through it. So I'm not going to stop you from going to go and book the beds from the company you normally book. I've used Amo beds, I've used Said, I've used Agritech, I've used Fidan, Chikun. I've used different strains of beds. So I don't think that's the problem here. It's all about getting things right. And like I said, we start from preparation. So much later, let's say tomorrow, I'll be getting in to let you know the few things we'll need. I showed you the carton earlier, so we'll let you know. I'll get you all those things, and then you can see it. I'm going to walk you through every detail of what I do, the cartons, whatever I use, and so that when my beds arrive, I wouldn't have to, you know, get jumpy. It looks as if I'm repeating some of the words. Yes, that's true, because at this point in time, it's very important that I have a wonderful 2 weeks, because there is a particular weight I'm targeting. And once I get that weight, I know I have gotten it right. So for now, from Elders Agro Services, we want to wish you a wonderful weekend. Don't forget to subscribe. Invite your friends who still want to learn about poultry business. I'll do the best I can. My name is Stile B. I'm by Bipa David, the MD, Elders Agro Services. Identity through quality. See you.